Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. A really simple video for you today. I'm assuming you're an absolute beginner in music theory. We just got off of Clubhouse debating about if music theory was important in music education. And I think it really is important to know how to navigate. Now, a lot of people make it super complicated. And I'm just a person who keeps it simple and easy. So that's one thing you could trust about me. If everything becomes complicated, I'll make it super simple for you. So with music theory, there's a couple main things you need to understand. Not that you need to understand everything, because sometimes the music theory you're learning, you can't even apply it to certain genres. So I'll keep it short. So we're using the plugin Hermes. This is my plugin. I'll leave a link below if you like the sound, but I'm using the preset called Pad Belly. And we're going to open up the piano roll. So in short, for the most part, in hip hop, in R&B, we're using what are called major chords or minor chords for the most part. There are other chords like augmented, diminished, seventh chords, dominant seventh, what other types of chords out there? Tritones. So don't complicate it, because rarely do you use those chords. Major, minor kind of make up the majority of the music that you're going to be writing. Okay. So once you learn this technique, it's super simple. I teach chord codes. This is the quickest way to get into music theory, period, hands down. All right, so this is how you do it. I'm literally gonna close my eyes to prove it to you. And I landed on D sharp. Okay, so we're gonna pull this up one octave because it's a little low. I can literally make either a major or minor chord starting anywhere on the keyboard. This is called chord codes. And the reason I'm starting here, just to show you how beginner this is, but how advanced it could be at the same exact time. This is my ultimate problem solving tool when it comes to writing chord progressions. So let's say we wanted to make a minor chord. There's a chord code to it. You can get that chord code for free with the link below. Okay, so here's how it works. You choose any key you want on the keyboard, hit that key. That's considered your point of rest or your zero point. This is the point where you start counting. This we call zero in the chord code. So this is called zero because it's a point of rest. There's no distance. Then we count up the keyboard to finish out the chord code. So every chord has a code. There's a code for a minor chord, a major chord, minor seventh, minor ninth, minor 11th, major, all the way through. So there's codes for each type of chord. So let me show you the minor chord code. So it's 0, 3, 7. So again, wherever you land is zero. So again, I could teach this to a photographer, a videographer, a drummer, and they'll learn how to play chords on a piano instantly without any other music theory. Okay, so this is zero. So all we got to do now is count up the keyboard to finish out the chord code. So again, the chord code here is 0, 3, 7. So it's zero, wherever you land, just count up the keyboard note by note. So it's 0, 1, 2, 3. Add that note in, 4, 5, 6, 7. Add that note in, and now you have a minor chord. No matter where you are on the keyboard, it's always going to be a minor chord. Now I'm going to show you a little more depth to it. So let's say you wanted to make a minor ninth chord. That chord code is 0, 3, 7, 10, 14. If I got my memory right, because I just came from the gym. So 0, 3, 7, 10, 14. So it's 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. That makes this a seventh chord, by the way, for those who understand music theory. So it's 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. We just made a minor nine chord without knowing anything, just using pure number. And I have a whole chord code chart you can download straight to your phone for reference, so you don't have to memorize this stuff. I don't want you to get overwhelmed thinking you have to go to school to learn how to play guitar and play piano just to make your first major nine chord. Like, you could do this with just understanding numbers. As long as you can count, you can make chords. I don't want you to be intimidated from this knowledge, because there's a beginner level that gets you really high level results. And there's also an advanced level that goes into the meta stuff if you want to take it further. So I have a whole chord code chart. It's absolutely free. Just go to busyworksbeats.com/music theory. I'll leave a link below because it's essential to your collection here. We just made a minor nine chord. I'll just show you the cool things you could do. So we can go from a minor nine and let's go to a major nine. So a major nine is a little bit different. And I'm going to kind of move a little more advanced for the people who are more advanced. So let's say you have one note in your head and you want to harmonize it, create a chord from one note in your head, basically how to translate the ideas in your head into the DAW. So the note I hear in my head is F. Now, Pharrell does this a lot. He'll switch from a minor to a major chord or vice versa. So let's go from a minor nine to a major nine, and then let's keep that same top note. So now we're not working it from zero, because wherever you landed, that's zero and you count upward. So that's the root note and you work until you fill out the chord. Now we're working backwards. So now I'm going to take the major 9 chord code, which is 0, 4, 7, 11, 14, and we're going to work backwards. So I'm just showing you the higher level of how this works. So in this case, since we're working backwards, we're going to start at 14, which is the highest note of the chord. So it's 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Now you have that Pharrell Neptune's vibe. Super simple. In this video, it probably didn't even take 10 minutes. You just learned the majority of music theory in about 10 minutes. Can you imagine what happens when you get the chord codes for one? So click the link below, go to busyworksbeats.com/musictheory. And I also have a music theory course, which goes into depth, like how to create melodies, modern melodies, how to create harmonies, modes, scales, intervals, all types of stuff. I go really deep with it. And it's for modern beat makers and people who want to understand music theory on a very, very, very simple, easy to understand level. So thank you for watching this video. I want you to like the video and share with your friends because this might unlock their brain to think, oh, I don't have to memorize a bunch of scales just to make a chord. So we're trying to free people from the confinements of the old system. So thank you. It's Game from BusyWorksBeats.com.